Welcome to my guide on how to play SWAT in Killing Floor 2. So SWAT is a pretty basic, straightforward class. He's a trashed killer perk. You're going to want to be focusing the smaller Zeds. He's not really meant for bigger Zeds, but he can get the job done. But yeah, I'm going to be going over all the skills you want to use. That's probably the most complex part about this perk, is knowing what skills to use. I'm going to be going over every single gun that SWAT has, which guns to be using, which guns to be avoiding, and just a little bit of gameplay at the end on how to deal with big Zeds and regular Zeds. Here are the skills for SWAT. SWAT is a class where at the very first wave, you want to get all your benefits and to help with your economy to save money and all that. So you want to take all the left skills here, then the right skill. You should never take battering ram for the most part. It's more of like I see a lot of noobs who use this skill. It really doesn't help as much as you think it does. The only time it's actually useful is if you're like hiding and you're trying to go through like a door or something like that, and you need to escape. Otherwise, this kind of doesn't help your team because it knocks everything down. So then the big Zed killers can't take down the Skrakes or flesh pounds, and it also messes with the extensions too. So it's more for solo play, but even then I would still always recommend taking rapid assault. So first wave, you want to take everything over here on the left side. These two skills here stack up, so you get 100% armor at the very first wave. So 100 armor right off the bat, which is super useful for saving money. If you can make sure you don't get hit as much during the first wave, you can pretty much have a full set of armor right then and there. Then close combat training, this gives you 100% more damage with your 9mm, your bashing, and your knife. It's very, very useful. You're probably going to run out of ammo with your MP7 the first wave. That's usually how it is. If you're playing single player, you should be fine, but for a 6-player Hell on Earth, you're definitely probably going to run out of your MP7, so this is where the 9mm and knife comes in. This skill here is very useful for the first wave. I would say by the second or third wave is usually when you want to get rid of this. At least until you get at least an MP5. Usually that's when I would swap this out. Suppression rounds. This helps for big Zeds. It helps for every Zed, but especially for Skrakes and flesh pounds. It gives you that few extra seconds to stumble them around and actually take them down. So very helpful survivability perk. It keeps your distance from the Zeds. Again, this stacks up with the other one. So after the first wave, this is what I like to do. I like to swap to tactical movement, cripple, and then eventually after wave 2 or 3, I swap to tactical reload. I sell my extra 9mm because I'm not really going to be using that after the first wave or two. Then this is the skill that you want to swap each and every single wave. During trader time, you want to swap to ammo vest during trader, get your ammo, refill your guns, drop your guns. So after the guns are dropped on the ground, swap to suppression rounds, then pick up your guns again, and you will still have the 30% ammo bonus. So you should never stay on this skill. You should only ever swap during trader. You might be asking, why do I not choose this during the very first wave? Because this is more for bigger Zeds, of course, but this does not work during the very first wave. It's a useless skill. You don't get that extra bonus during the very first wave, so that's why you want to keep doing this. So yeah, just go back and forth between this during trader so you can get that extra 30% ammo, because it's very, very useful. You're gonna be kind of just mowing down through your magazines because you have super high rate of fire. So yeah, these are the skills I like to use. So tactical movement, this is going to give you an extra edge in speed, so you can be a lot more mobile, especially during crouching and iron sights. Very, very useful for keeping your distance. Reload speed is going to keep up your DPS. You're going to be going through your magazines pretty fast. Now, holding down the trigger most of the time, you're not really going to be tap firing that much. The stumble power is going to be very helpful for big Zeds. The cripple is going to make Zeds a little bit slower, so 30% slower of Zeds around you, which is going to make it so flesh pounds and Skrakes don't actually touch you, hopefully. And it helps with other Zeds, of course, as well. And then rapid assault, it makes it so you can just hold down the trigger and you don't have to reload or anything like that. And yeah, these are the skills that I use for SWAT. So you start off with an MP7 and dual 9mm pistols. So your MP7 is going to be the first gun that you get. It's okay. I mean, for wave one, it gets the job done. After wave one, I would recommend just getting rid of it and going right for an MP5. An MP5 is pretty much as an MP7, but more damage. So and this thing has barely any damage. It's even the 9mm has more damage than the MP7 has, so it works for clots and everything like that. It doesn't have that much DPS to really camp or really do any. It's not very good. MP7, it gets the job done for wave one, but after that, definitely sell it and go for an MP5, or you could go for a MAC-10, but it's just MAC-10 has what? I think, yeah, MAC-10 is slightly more damage than MP5, but it's 650 dosh versus 900, and it's not really worth the extra price for it, but it works, I guess. If you really like the MAC-10, you can go for it. So you have to wave one, sell your MP7, and sell the dual 9mm, or keep the dual 9mm. It depends how much money you have. Usually what I do after wave one, I sell the MP7, I go for the MP5, and I keep my dual 9mm. I usually keep this for wave two or three. Even during wave two or three, I find myself running out of ammo with my main gun here. So I keep the skill for extra damage for my 9mm. And usually by wave three or four, I end up selling this. And usually I try to keep the MP5, and I usually just go straight for the G36. And then eventually I sell my MP5 for a HRG nail gun. That's usually what my loadout tends to look like. Now let me go over every single weapon that SWAT has. So SWAT is a class that most of his guns they get the job done. SWAT is a trash killer, so most of these guns are going to do a fine enough job. I'm just going to go down one by one, explain which guns are decent and which guns you should kind of just not use. MP7, that's your starter gun. After wave one, I would recommend just completely selling it. It's not very good. MP5, that's the good early gun. That's usually what I buy right after. That's what I buy during wave two or three. I keep the MP5 for as long as I can. Tommy gun kind of sucks. I know I kind of skipped over when I was talking about starter guns, but there's a reason. The Tommy gun has insane recoil. I find Tommy gun actually better for commando, which is kind of weird considering it's a SWAT gun, but it's just the tap fire is pretty good on commando, and the huge magazine can make it good for Zed time. I mean, even if you could control the recoil on it, it takes so much effort to actually do that, that it's just I would never use a Tommy gun personally. I would always just go for the MP5 or even the MAC-10 instead. Otherwise, just avoid the Tommy gun if you can. HRG nail gun, this is going to be the main big Zed killer on this class. SWAT isn't really a big Zed killer, but he can support with flesh pounds, and like, he's good enough for like quarter pounds and the occasional flash pound. He can take care of them, especially if you use your flashbangs. You can stun bigger Zeds and then take them down pretty easily with the nail gun. I like to upgrade the nail gun like once or twice. Usually when I use it, it gives that extra damage, which helps for flash pounds. Otherwise, I don't usually use the nail gun for like smaller Zeds very often. I usually use a different gun. A P90. P90 is kind of like if the Tommy gun was better. Like, the P90 is if the Tommy gun didn't have stupid recoil, you could actually manage it. I don't use a P90 very often, but it's an option that you can use. It's not a meta gun, but it works, and I think it's a decent enough gun. It's very like mid-tier. It's good, but it's not amazing. This is a gun that I used to think I wasn't that into, but it's actually pretty good. It has very good damage, but the main issue on it is its rate of fire is pretty slow, which makes it not super great for trash Zeds. There's better options, like the P90 is going to be better, or the G36 is going to be better for trash Zeds than the UMP. But the UMP is still good. I think the UMP is better than the P90. Same carry weight, just a little bit more money. So if I had to choose between these two, I would always choose the UMP over the P90 personally. The HRG Stunner, this is a HRG gun. I don't like HRG guns for the most part. I tried using this, it kind of sucks. It's got very little ammunition. Its main gimmick is that it can stun Zeds. Its alt fire is kind of like a flashbang thing. It's just really not that helpful. You think having a ton of flashbangs like that would be amazing, especially for like scrapes and flesh pounds, but realistically, your job as a SWAT isn't to take down big Zeds. And even if it was, the ammunition and the damage it has kind of sucks, where it's not going to be that useful. Yeah, just avoid the HRG Stunner from my experience. The Chris SMG, this used to be the best gun for SWAT way before the G36 was ever a thing. Way back then, I used to use the SMG with the P90 and the MP5. That was a pretty good build. The Chris is the highest rate of fire gun for SWAT. I think it might be the highest rate of fire gun in the game. Very, very good for trash, and it's also very, very good for scrakes. The damage it has isn't the best, so it's not going to be amazing for flashbounds, but it still works for flashbounds. It's just the HRG nail gun or the G36 is going to be better for flashbounds. For most things, those guns are going to be better than the Chris. So it's kind of obsolete now. Like, compared to every other gun, the Chris is still one of the best SWAT guns besides the two meta guns that I mentioned here. Chris SMG is always a very good option. Then we have the first DLC gun, the Riot Shield and Glock. This is a very, like, a mid-tier kind of gun. It's very expensive, has a ton of carry weight. Actually has the most carry weight gun out of anything for SWAT. The damage is kind of lackluster. It has a very high rate of fire and a lot of ammunition, but besides those two advantages, it's an okay gun. There's better option. The Chris is going to be better, or the G36. So the Riot Shield is more like a gun if you want a different change of pace, but otherwise I would never use the Riot Shield that often. It's not that great of a weapon. It's a cool gun. It's definitely very cool, but that's really the only thing it has going for it, is that it just looks cool. You can get away with using it, but it's not your best option. Then we have the other DLC gun, the G36. This is kind of broken. It is the best SWAT gun. So this is going to be the main trash Zed killer. The one cool thing that this gun has, it can penetrate through armor. So gliders, you can just aim for the head and you can just easily take them down, kill them in a few hits. It's also very useful for the Matriarch, because you can just shred through his armor. Even for the Abomination, you can just completely shred through his armor. So this is a very good weapon for bosses and trash and pretty much everything. So yeah, it's kind of broken. It's the weapon you should pretty much always take. If you don't have this weapon, then that kind of sucks for you. But if you're going to buy any gun for Killing Floor 2, this is definitely the gun you want to buy. It's just objectively the best SWAT gun besides the nail gun, which the nail gun, again, it's mostly for flashbounds. The HRG Bastion, this is a very meh kind of gun. It's okay. The damage isn't that great on it. It has extremely good high rate of fire, but it's also very expensive. 2,000 is a lot of money. You're kind of better off just buying the G36 over the Bastion. Bastion's main gimmick is if you press the alt fire. Here, let me show you. So if you press the alt fire, you can bring up this little shield here, which is very, very useful for flashbounds or kiting. You gotta manage the energy on it so you don't run out of it. But yeah, if you hold this down, you take a huge decrease in damage. So if you're gonna be using this gun, you may as well always have this up for as much as you can. So it's an option, but otherwise it's not going to be the best option. It's still a fun gun to use and you can get away with using it. The HMTech 201 SMG, this is one of the weakest guns that SWAT has besides the MP7. I only use this so we don't have a medic on the team, but otherwise it's also very little carry weight. So sometimes what I like to do is I grab the G36, the HRG nail gun, and then I'll pick up a HMTech 201. For side heals. This is more like an early wave gun or a backup gun, but otherwise the damage is pretty bad on it and you don't want to be using it for solo play, or if you have a medic, you don't really need to buy this. The last real gun that SWAT has is the MAC-10. The MAC-10 is a solid beginner weapon. It's like the MP5 in a way, where it does a little bit more damage than the MP5, but it's the price for it isn't that great. I don't think it's worth using over the MP5, but it's another gun if you want a different change of pace. Otherwise, I don't use the MAC-10 that often. If I get tired of the MP5, I'll use the MAC-10. The main issue I have with this gun is that the fire it has kind of does this weird, annoying stumble. If you have big Zed killers on your team, this can make it a lot harder for them to take down scrapes and fleshpounds, because it can make Zed stumble around and all that, and it can get pretty annoying. So definitely you want to be conscious when you use this gun. But yeah, still a solid early gun overall. Then we have the dual 9mm pistols. These are the weapons we're going to be spawning with. It's after the first wave, or first few waves, you eventually just want to get rid of them. Then, of course, a dashing gun. I'm going to be saying this for every single guide here. Do not use this gun. This is a stupid gun. This is a DLC gun, so you might not even see this. Or maybe it is free. I don't remember if it's DLC or not, but definitely do not use this gun. And yeah, that's every single gun that SWAT has. So the best loadout that SWAT has is a G36 and an HOG nail gun. This is going to be your main big trash killer. This is going to be the big Zed killer, mostly for fleshbounds. You're going to want to upgrade this twice for that extra damage. The G36 isn't super necessary to upgrade, but it can help a little bit. It's pretty expensive to upgrade the G36, so sometimes what I like to do is I just don't upgrade this, just buy an HMTAC 101. I can do some side heals for my team. That's the first build that you want to be using. This is the meta build, the best build that you can use for SWAT. This is what I use, honestly, like 90% of the time when I play this class. The other builds for SWAT work, but they're not that great in comparison. This is just always going to be so much better. Another build I have is the Chris SMG, the P90, and the MP5. This is like the classic loadout that I used to use before the G36 and the nail gun was ever added. So like way back then when SWAT was first initially added, this is what I used to use. The main issue with this build is that fleshbounds is going to be kind of an issue, but for Scrakes, Chris is going to do a very, very good job at that, and you have a ton of ammunition with this build. So if you have a big Zed killer on your team, this is an option. This is a pretty good trash killer. G36 is still always going to be objectively better than all of these guns here. So another build is the UMP, the HRG nail gun, and an HMTEC 101. So I like to upgrade the UMP twice, the nail gun twice. So flesh pounds, and this will be for regular Zeds and Scrakes. It has a pretty good amount of damage, so Scrakes are going to get taken down pretty fast with this build. And that's kind of it when it comes to builds. I don't really experiment much with this perk. The first two builds I mentioned are what I use most of the time. There's other builds you can use, like if you want to use the Bastion. If you use the energy shield on it, you can take way less damage, so that's pretty nice to have. Probably swap the G36 for a nail gun if you wanted. So your trash killer, your big Zed killer, or you could even, I don't know, do something crazy like the Bastion and the Riot Shield. Yeah, that's all the builds that I use for SWAT. There's not really many tips or tricks I can really show you for this class. It's kind of, for this perk, it's very, very straightforward. You know, aim for the head. Make sure you just pull down the trigger most of the time. You don't really need to be tap firing. So yeah, for quarter pounders, you don't really need to be using your flashbangs. You can just hold down the trigger and your stumble will kind of do its job there to help you. So yeah, you don't need to use flashbangs for quarter pounders. For flashbangs, I would always use flashbangs for them if you can. You only have 5 flashbangs, so you want to make sure you utilize them as best as you can. SWAT can have like his own lane, or just be at the main lane and make sure you focus all the trash. For flashbangs, just go up to it, throw down your flashbang, stunned. Just hold down the trigger, aim for the head. You probably want to back up a little earlier than that. But yeah, it's pretty easy to take down a fleshbound with the nail gun upgraded twice. For Scrakes, I don't really like using the nail gun for the Scrakes. I usually use my G36. I just find that a lot easier. You don't have to use flashbangs for Scrakes either. So you just hold down the trigger, even though that little stumble helps you. So yeah, you can easily take down a Scrakes without it ever even touching you. Especially when you're using the right skills here, you got that extra mobility, you can just back up, keep shooting them, and the stumble and the damage will be enough to kill it before it ever even gets near you. But you can use flashbangs on it, especially if you struggle at killing them, or if it's like right in your face or something like that. How to take down big Zeds is kind of common sense. Just use your flashbangs as best as you can. Make sure you use this nail gun as best as you can. Just hold down the trigger pretty much. G36, good for Scrakes and for all the smaller Zeds. Let me just spawn a bunch of trash Zeds. I mean, I don't really need to show you how to do this, but I'll do it anyways, because why not? Very high rate of fire kind of perk. Just hold down the trigger, gets the job done. That extra reload speed helps a ton. They always just aim for the head. For these guys, Husk, you can just aim for the fuel tank or the head, doesn't really matter. You can also use your knife, mostly for flashbangs. It's kind of hard to do this for Scrakes, but say if you have one rage or something like that and you can't kill it in time, or if you have to reload, just swap out your knife, parry it, take a lot less damage. That's something I use for every single perk in this game. There's not really much else I need to say about this. So yeah, if you like this guide, well, I hope you liked it. If you like this guide, I'll hopefully do more of this kind of stuff. And yeah, I will see you next time.